Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video, I'm going to share the clinical case of CM-guided articular branch nerve block in a patient with chronic shoulder pain. This clinical case and technique are based on our original article. Please review the lecture video about the articular branch of the shoulder joint if you did not watch it. This is the model of needle approach to the lateral trunk of the suprascapular nerve. This is the model of needle approach to the superior nerve to the subscapularis. Let me describe my patient. She is 82 years old and has had chronic intractable right shoulder pain. On physical examination, she showed a capsular pattern of limitation and pain. Simple X-ray shows sclerosis and depression of a greater tubercle, marginal spur formation of the medial inferior aspect of the humerus head. An ultrasound image along the long biceps tendon shows bisuspital fluid. Long axial image along the subscapularis tendon shows marginal erosion in the lateral edge of articular surface and degeneration in the distal tendon. Long axial image along the supraspinatus tendon shows cortical erosion in the tendon footprint of the greater tubercle and degeneration of supraspinatus tendon. Short axial image along the biceps tendon, supraspinatus, and subscapularis tendon. There is a diffuse irregular cortical erosion and tendinosis. Long axial image along the infraspinatus tendon shows mild joint effusion of posterior joint space. Let's go to the clinical practice. Put the patient's oblique spine decubitus position. Put the support to the back and shoulder would help her stay easy. Find the notch between the clavicle and scapular spine through gentle palpation. Rotate the CM until true AP view to the scapular bone. Watch the CM scapular image. It is a good CM position. Advance the needle along the anterior border of the scapular spine. If I move the needle too posteriorly, the needle would pass the cortical line of the floor of supraspinatus fossa. This is an illustration of how I did it before. I adjusted the needle direction. The needle tip was aimed toward the 1 cm medial to the lateral superior edge of scapular glenoid and advanced until it contacted the scapular bone at the superior surface of suprascapular fossa. After needle touched the bone, the C-arm was rotated to obtain the scapular Y view to visualize the suprascapular fossa. I put in the contrast media. Look at the contrast pattern on AP view. I put in a mixture of bupivacaine and dexamethasone palmitate. We have to help her to change her position into a supine. Scrub the anterior shoulder for needle insertion for the superior nerve to the subscapularis. Note the coracoid process. Tilt the C-arm to open the space from the coracoid process. Put the needle on a slight right oblique C-arm guidance. If I put the needle on true AP view to the joint line, I may have a chance to injure the brachial plexus. After the needle touched the bone, the C-arm was rotated to obtain the scapular Y view to visualize the subscapular fossa. I put in the contrast media. Contrast pattern on true AP view. I put in a mixture of bupivacaine with a dexamethasone palmitate. Thank you for watching. See you again.